We decide who that is right now. Jose Johnson's going to drive and kick to Kateri Poole. They'll go inside to LaDasia Williams, who's coming off a season high. Flage in the corner. A little too much, and LaDasia Williams is going to be whistled for the foul. Let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups. They are brought to you by Capital One. Brooke mentioned Haley Cavender. She is one of the twins for this Miami team that transferred in. But Destiny Harden, she had the big shot to beat Indiana in the second round.
She said she wanted the ball. I expect her to come in and be an immediate impact from the jump. She'll play, start out inside, but she's got a perimeter ability to her game as well. She can knock down the three.
So jump ball possession arrow stays with Miami. Just looking at this matchup over the last day and a half, it's crazy how similar these teams are.
Well, both of these teams really feed on getting the ball in the paint. Over 50% of their points, both teams, have come from inside, down low.
Jaleah Williams, the point guard for Miami.
See, man-to-man defense, both of these teams starting out aggressively, but really sagging in the paint.
Here's the starting lineup for LSU. Alexis Morris, the four biggest free throws of her life. She hit them at the end of their Sweet 16 game to send them to the Elite Eight.
Calm, cool, and collected.
Alexis Morris, the veteran on this team, played for Kim Mulkey in her freshman season at Baylor. Made stops at Rutgers, Texas A&M, and now LSU. Haley Cavender working off the screen from Pendande. Harden got loose all by herself. Angel Reese bringing it down the floor.
On Friday, Reese brought the ball in transition down the floor as opposed to running down the floor. I think LSU is more effective when Alexis Morris is the ball handler.
Morris pokes that one away. Reese is going to give it to her, and it's Alexis Morris with the layup.
LSU has averaged in the NCAA tournament about 12 points a game, points off turnovers. Nope, there's margin from their opponents.
And they're scoring 12 more points off turnovers than their opponents. They average about 20 points off turnovers a game this season. That one's poked away from Jaleah Williams. This one, this time by Poole, and Angel Reese working a bit short on the layup. Destiny Harden gets it back. Jaleah Williams trying to jump it off to Pendande, and that's going to be a turnover. Well, you want experience in this tournament? Kim Mulkey has it. Four Final Four appearances. She's won three national titles. This is her 11th Elite Eight appearance. Can that be a factor for LSU, her having coached in this round before?
Well, the thing that Kim Mulkey brings is a mentality. She knows what it takes. She even practiced in shoot around this morning, giving the instructions from the bench. The players went and sat on the bench and then came out and carried out the plan.
Ten seconds now for LSU. Morris calling for the screen from Williams. And that's going to be a foul on Lashay Dwyer. You know, entering the tournament, Katie Meyer in her 18th season, Miami had a 3% chance to make the Elite Eight. Katie Meyer told us today, look, you have, what, maybe 35 game days to wake up and be great, and that's how she wants Miami to feel today.
That's what she said, just be great today. They have been the underdog all along the way and have been able to prevail. And that, they come back with 16 points against Indiana, or 17, they were down 17 from Indiana and stayed collected. And that's one of the things that Katie said in shoot around this morning. She said, stay calm and stay organized. Right now, LSU's defense has had Miami very rattled.
Yeah, five possessions for Miami, four turnovers. Dwyer going to Cavender on the back door. Layup won't fall. Angel Reese will give it back to Alexis Morris.
And right now, Miami just playing straight up, man-to-man. And I heard Kim Mulkey yell at her team to get the ball inside.
You've got two great options inside if you're LSU and LaDasia Williams and Angel Reese. 7 seconds. Angel Reese hesitated. That shot rolls out. Jasmine Roberts gets it to fall, and no foul called.
How did she get by two players and get that finish?
Quick step. Jasmine Roberts had a career-high 26 points in the Sweet 16 against Villanova. Poole recovers. Here goes Lashay Dwyer. Up ahead to Roberts. Patience. Back-to-back buckets.
We're going to see a lot of this from both teams. They're so similar. They're athletic. They're quick. They like to get production off their defense. Miami all over Flajay Johnson.
Angel Reese, she loses the battle to Lola Pendande. It should be a fun matchup to keep an eye on. Pendande and Reese in the paint. And that's the second on Lashay Dwyer.
Jasmine Roberts has been hot in this tournament. The drive by two LSU defenders. Wasn't a problem. Just get out ahead and run the floor. That's the easiest way to score over tough defense.
Miami in its very first Elite Eight, seeking its first Final Four. LSU looking to get to a sixth Final Four today. Quick buckets on either end. Alexis Morris.
Morris is going to have to be a major factor for LSU today. She can't coast along. They can't just depend on Angel Reese.
Destiny Harden is fouled by Kateri Poole. It's been an incredible ride for Miami. It's not over yet, but we look back at how the Hurricanes got to their very first Elite Eight. He's going, look at the margin of victory in the first three rounds of the tournament. This is the combined smallest margin of victory in the first three games in this tournament's history. They've won all three by a total of 8 points.
So in the Oklahoma State game, they came back from 17 down. When they played Indiana, they kept that same mentality. They were playing as if they were behind. Then they were up 20 against Villanova, and they then referred back to that Oklahoma State game and said what they did to Oklahoma State, they were not going to allow to happen to them.
Now, there's a toughness about this program. It starts with their head coach, Katie Meyer, and you know she's got, what'd she tell us, 40 family members, including, you see Katie's mom there on the right, Phyllis, her wife Hunter on the left, and her mom, Phyllis, has been such an inspiration for her. Katie lost her dad before she was born. He died in a plane crash, and Phyllis has just been the rock of the family, and Katie's taken that on.
Well, Katie said that her mom and her house was always like the place that everybody came to. She like pseudo adopted kids from the neighborhood. She was just has that loving openness about her and really embracing people around her. Angel Reese is not getting any open looks. Pendande has her pushed out off the block.
And guys, despite the turnovers, a very positive timeout and huddle report from Miami player-led, talking a lot about Jasmine Roberts. Look for her to get the ball again, saying they can't guard you one-on-one. But she's been a big contributor in this one. Katie Meyer coming to the bench and also saying your defense is unbelievable. They just have to settle into it offensively.
Now, Jasmine Roberts, she's number 4 in orange for Miami.
Destiny Harden lost a contact.
And she's heading over to the Miami bench. Going to give Harden some time to put the contact back in. She's a grad student, started her career at West Virginia. She's just been so important for this Miami program, especially going on this run.
Destiny Harden is such a fierce competitor. She's also as good off the court as she is on. She's also a member of the Honor Society.
Spearman in for Miami, number 32 in orange. Jalea Williams saw an opening and took all of it.
Jalea Williams is so quick off the bounce. LSU is really finding it hard to find ways to get the ball to Angel Reese.
Yeah, Angel Reese is 0-for-4 as Alexis Morris scores. LSU had hit just one of its previous seven field goals.
Watch, Jalea Williams just blows by Kateri Poole. No help rotation. Angel Reese is there, but she stayed back. The rotation's got to be early. I mean, that's one of the things that Miami is going to try to do is attack the basket, and especially going at Angel Reese, try to get her into some foul trouble.
Well, right now, Kateri Poole just picked up her second foul for LSU, so she's taking a seat. Somebody has lost a shoe, and it's Angel Reese.
You know what happened last time she lost a shoe?
Blocked shot. Deja Williams is holding the shoe. The shot off by Roberts. Jalea Williams comes in for the offensive board. Carla Arrivet's no.
LaDeja's still got the shoe. And Angel goes out of bounds to get it. Now, if she scores right here, I'm done.
She has not scored yet. She's going to the free throw line, though.
Adversity does not slow down Angel Reese.
Lazaria Spearman has whistled for her first foul.
She puts her shoe on, hustles back in, post up, call for it, and then take it to the rack.
This is the new Kobe 6 Grinches they got, too. Vanessa Bryant reaching out to the team, giving them access so LSU could purchase the new shoes for the squad. They look pretty cool.
Those are nice. LSU doesn't look settled in. A little frustrated offensively.
What do you think about the shots they're getting?
I don't think they're getting good shots, and I think that Miami has a lot to do with it.
That's the second foul on Spearman for Miami. So Lola Pendande is going to come back in for the Canes. You know, the Miami men and women are both playing in the Elite Eight. The Miami men just finished up, and they are going to the Final Four.
Imagine what that university would be like if the women were also able to punch their ticket. Neither one of these teams have ever been this far. These players haven't been this far. Miami as a program has never been this far. So you got to believe there's a little bit of nerves that are affecting both of these teams.
Man, LSU hasn't been to the Elite Eight since 2008. So it's been a minute for the Tigers, too, to be on this stage. Reese with the rebound. Looking up ahead to LaDeja Williams in transition. No, rebound by Pendande. LSU shooting 25% from the field. Cavender.
Both teams rushing. Trying to force it. They need to, in the half court, get two or three passes.
And Angel Reese will go back to the free throw line. She's taken more free throws than anyone in the nation. First foul on Lola Pendande of Miami. The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Both of these teams need to settle in. Katie Meyer gave her team like four or five what she called comfort plays. She wants them to stay calm and stay organized. And she said when it gets hectic or very chaotic, run these things, very simple plays, like a floppy action where you have a post on each block and the guards just play on the wing, get into a ball screen, or a high ball screen, or a horn set.
Three points for Angel Reese, all from the free throw line. Meanwhile, Miami hasn't scored in 2 minutes. There's Williams looking for something, gives it back up to Destiny Harden. Harden trying to go over Angel Reese, it's tough.
Yeah, Harden had an open shot from the top of the key, tried to get closer and came right into a bigger defender.
And Alexis Morris turns it over. Hannah Cavender to Area Vets for the three. Under a minute to go in the first quarter, both offenses trying to find their footing here on this big stage.
Angel Reese has got to go to work.
Gets her own rebound. Can't finish, still no field goals for Angel Reese.
And you're not gonna catch Delia Williams.
What do you think about the pace right now?
Well, it's fast, but they're missing layups. They're rushing. There's a difference in going fast and being in a hurry. And you don't need to be in a hurry. Go fast, but then compose.
Angel Reese will sit down for the last 23 seconds. Carla Arjavets just whistled for her first foul. Kyla Oldacre checks in for Miami. This is last tier Poa at the free throw line for LSU. The NCAA Women's Championship continues tonight with the Elite Eight. Runs through next Sunday when we crown a champion. Every game is on the ESPN family of networks. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. One of two for Poa, and Miami can take the last shot of the quarter. They have missed their last eight shots.
Destiny Harden needs to get a touch.
Anna Cavender looking for Harden for three. Off the front of the iron. Jasmine Carson on the move. Off the fingertips of Samaya Smith. LSU ending on a 6-0 run at the end of the first quarter. Katie Meyer will talk to
Maryland Terps.
Watching these two teams right now, what stood out about the first 10 minutes?
That they're both nervous. They've got to calm down and settle in. And just look at this. This is just another game. You can't put too much pressure on yourselves and let the offense come to you. But they both have locked down defensively.
Alexis Morris.
Miami came out in the zone out of that timeout.
Now Kim Mulkey told us she was expecting to see multiple defenses from Miami. Carla Arjavets on the move in transition, and she scores right over Alexis Morris. Alexis Morris, the only player for LSU to hit a field goal. She's 3 for 4, the rest of team 0 for 13. Jaleah Williams, last touch by LSU.
Miami running in transition. Look at how wide Williams and Cavender are running the lane. That leaves the middle main street for Arjavets to go straight down the middle. She kept it, made a good decision, didn't overpass, and went all the way to the rim.
Jaleah Williams trying to create some space for herself. And Oldacre is fouled underneath. That's on LaDasia Williams, her first.
Oldacre is a 6'6 freshman. Battle inside, you get that early position. She has the height advantage.
And she's a McDonald's All-American. Missed the first 12 games of the season with a medical condition, so that set her back in learning the system, getting that game experience. She was thrown into ACC play.
Well, and as a freshman, when you're coming in as a post player, to catch up with the speed and physicality takes time.
6 seconds. Stays with Miami, 4.8 on the shot clock.
You know Miami's got a 6 second or less play.
We've seen it a couple of times. Destiny Harden might get it. They go Oldacre. She's double teamed.
And the two-man game, Alexis Morris and Angel Reese, they've got to try to make something happen.
Angel Reese is 0 for 6. Morris misses that. Harden on the trail.
LSU's offense looks as disjointed as it did in the SEC tournament when Tennessee made their run.
That was in this same arena here in Greenville. They lost to Tennessee in the semifinals of that tournament, and they've used it as motivation coming in to the NCAA tournament.
I wonder if they're having flashbacks.
Jasmine Roberts at the elbow.
Roberts is averaging 18 points a game in this NCAA tournament.
And shooting 58% from the field.
We heard Katie Meyer tell Brooke that Jazz has that swag.
That one bounces out for Morris. Yeah, Jasmine Roberts definitely has that swag. Jaleea Williams trying to dump it off. Back the other way, Flage.
If the freshman gets going, Flage Johnson for LSU, that might swing the momentum for the Tigers.
That snaps an 0 for 10 streak by Flage Johnson. She was 0 for 7 yesterday.
Destiny Harden wants it against Angel Reese.
7 seconds for Miami. Harden. Turnover. Sixth turnover by Miami. Flage and Morris, the only two LSU Tigers that have hit a field goal.
LSU is going to need to hit from the perimeter to open up the paint.
Alexis Morris with 8 now.
Break a play to make a play. Flage Johnson now has the assignment of guarding Jasmine Roberts.
Oldacre with the rebound, but it's knocked away by Alexis Morris. Eventually, Flage picks it up. Angel Reese, free throws coming.
This might be what gets Flage Johnson going. She struggled against Villanova, 0 for 7, so attacking the basket in transition. It's a good start. And then Luther, has Luther showed up for Alexis Morris?
Yeah, Lex Luther is Alexis Morris's alter ego. Sometimes Luther kicks in.
Well, and Kim Mulkey wants Luther to show up early instead of when LSU's got their backs against the wall.
Morris's percentages, though, down in the NCAA tournament, came into this game. First three games, she's shooting 32% from the field. Two more free throws for Angel Reese. She's already set an LSU single season record in free throws made and free throws attempted. She's attempted more free throws this season than any other player in the nation. Look at Jasmine Roberts, 10 points.
She has been unstoppable in this NCAA tournament. She can take it off the bounce. She's been hitting threes.
That's a sophomore who averaged 8 minutes a game last year.
She worked her way into the starting lineup.
Angel Reese going up against Pendande. And she's fouled by Harden.
Wow, she's enjoying attacking the freshman.
Yeah, guys, that was a focus in the huddle. And as you know, a player, if they're going to give you some type of room and then smile at you, you know it plants a seed. Angel Reese telling Flaje Johnson, hey, you need to take that personally. Flaje kind of tossed the towel down, but you could tell she felt that intensity to step her game up. Kim Mulkey giving Flaje a bit of a smile, too, in that huddle. Let's see how she responds.
And I know that Flaje Johnson has a big personality like Angel Reese. And anytime, and she has great respect for Angel Reese. So if Angel Reese has challenged her, I can expect that she's going to try to turn it up. But right now, there is no stopping Jasmine Roberts.
Look at her go, 12 points. Remember, this is a sophomore now. She averaged just under 2 points per game last season. Destiny Harden told us, I call her my twin because I told her, you got to learn the system and it's going to help you. She really hit the film room in the offseason.
Well, if there's a system that she needed to learn, and that was to go off the bounce, she has learned that very well. Again, scoring off the bounce with Flaje Johnson trying to guard her one-on-one.
It's funny, too. Jasmine told us, I decided I was going to focus on one thing coming into the season, and that was my rebounding.
I know. I thought she was going to say her jumper or three.
No.
She said she was going to focus on rebound.
Take the pressure off the offense, and it'll come.
Absolutely.
And as of today, Roberts leading all players in this game with 12 points. Possession arrow stays with Miami.
Think about this. Miami is playing to take the program for the first time to the Final Four.
Already took it to Miami's first Elite Eight. Here they are. Beat Villanova on Friday. LSU cannot stop Jasmine Roberts right now.
And Miami's going to continue to feed the beast. Number four in orange saw Katie Meyer give a fist bump to her coaching staff. Right now, things are going to continue to be run to Roberts.
Yeah, only three players for Miami have scored because Roberts has 14 of their 18 points. LSU with another chance. Flaje to Angel Reese. Reese still does not have a field goal. Now 0 for 8 to start this game. Foul on LSU's Samaya Smith, her first.
Angel Reese is 0 for 8. Lola Pendande has done a terrific job defending. You're going to watch when the ball goes inside to Reese. Pendande at times is jumping back, not to foul, and just forcing Angel to miss inside but be in position then to not allow her to get the offensive rebound.
Hang on there, Coach Beck.
I had you. I was going to save you. Everybody's good. Angel Reese is playing somebody's defense, I'll tell you that.
Into Smith, back out to Reese.
You see, Miami is icing the screen, not allowing Alexis Morris to come off the screen, and Angel Reese is away from the basket.
Samaya Smith with another offensive rebound and the putback. 10 points off turnovers for LSU.
And how will Jasmine Roberts get another look?
She's got Morris guarding her right now. 8 seconds. Area vets. Samaya Smith blocked the shot. Harden. We have not had a three-pointer made in this game by either team. Six-0 run for LSU. the Alexis Morris bucket. Watched her play, you know that to be true. 7 points still, all those coming from the free throw line, and 7 rebounds. Reminder, she has 31 double-doubles on the season. That ties an SEC single-season record. A double-double here would give her the record all to herself.
We've seen Angel be frustrated in the first half, and in the second half, she's been able to find those counter moves, find those corrections, and be productive. Can she do that today?
Offensive foul. And that's on Pendande. That's her second.
Last year, Poa, the guard stepping in right there and taking the charge.
She loves to score in the paint. They're 8-for-18 from the field inside the paint, but outside the paint, 0-for-10. It's an LSU team that averages 38 paint points per game. Still not shooting for the best percentage, 29% for the game. Nope. Poe on the inbound. Morris back to Samaya Smith. She's driving into the lane.
That's a freshman for LSU. Samaya Smith has been a huge impact inside with the struggles of Angel Reese. Number 5 in white has been able to be productive.
Not sure what the stoppage was. It was not a foul call. It was a delay of game warning on Angel Reese for grabbing the basketball, and then Jasmine Roberts with the score. She has Miami's last 10 points.
Well, and LSU has switched up. It was Flajay Johnson on Roberts. That time it was Alexis Morris. It doesn't seem to matter who's guarding her.
Travel on Reese. Shot clock still on here for Miami as we wind down the second quarter. Hurricanes have hit 4 of their last 5. Oldacre can't go around Reese.
Now how is LSU going to get the ball to Angel Reese?
Alexis Morris has got to go here. The deep 3. LSU leading at the half, 26-20. But it hasn't been pretty on either side.
It hasn't been. Points in the paint, only 12 for Miami, only 18 by LSU.
Angel Reese is with Brooke.
Angel, I know over 9 for you, but phenomenal defense by you and your team. How do you get into the rhythm of this game?
I'm just going to let the game come to me. I'm missing a lot of shots, but my teammates and coaches are putting a lot of confidence in me, so I'm going to keep shooting. We're up right now, but I'm going to keep playing our defense today.
All right, Angel, thank you.
Thank you.
Angel Reese, 7 points, all of those coming from the free throw line, 8 rebounds. LSU. Jasmine Roberts for Miami, 8-for-10. The rest of Miami's team, 2-for-18.
Now for Miami also, Destiny Harden hasn't made a field goal either for the Hurricanes.
And she's their second leading scorer at 12 points per game. Here's Haley Cavender short on the 3. Brooke, what was the conversation with this Miami group?
You know, the team was actually really loose coming out of the locker room. Saw some smiles, a couple of laughs, and then Katie Meyer comes out and says, hey, Miami, how about we get to the free throw line? Courtney, as you mentioned, no free throws by Miami in that first half. Also, 0-for-9 for Miami from deep. She wants to see some 3 balls falling.
Now, we haven't seen a 3 ball on either side, Brooke.
Well, we knew these teams love to score in the paint, so that's not too surprising, but I am surprised that Destiny and Angel have yet to hit a shot.
Right on Thank you. She heard you. Angel Reese with her first field goal of this game.
Well, I expected that to change. You saw Angel Reese score. You had Haley Cavender for Miami, a drive and attack the basket, because she was scoreless in that first half as well.
And she's Miami's leading scorer, 12 and a half points per game. Lola Pendande is shaken up on this play here, holding her stomach. So Lazarius Spearman has entered. They're gonna help Lola Pendande off the floor. She did a really good job on Angel Reese defensively in that first half.
She was huge defensively. I think she got elbowed in the midsection. When Flage Johnson was trying to go through that screen.
And so the training staff helping Lola Pendande over on the Miami bench area. We'll keep an eye on her. Eight seconds for Jaleah Williams. Shot clock did not reset. It didn't hit iron. Got the shot off in time, but it rolls out.
In that first half, too, Courtney, Kateri Poole got into some early foul trouble. So she spent a majority of the time on the bench. That will slow down LSU's offense.
Yeah, what do you like about when Kateri Poole is on the floor for the Tigers?
Well, Poole is a threat from the three-point line. So she would really pull the defense of Miami out and open up the lane for Angel Reese.
And she shoots 40-plus percent from three. Reese misses. Haley Cavender controlling it. The long two from Cavender.
You see, Jaleah Williams, she is the hype person for Miami. She said she's not gonna let anybody steal her joy. She wants to bring the light, even in dark situations.
Yeah, Jaleah Williams, so important. Just a bright personality in this Miami locker room.
And her presence on the floor and how she approaches every day, that smile on her face.
And Brooke, she had a pretty good one to compare herself to, talking about Jaleah Williams and how about old Magic Johnson?
Yeah, you gotta love that. Straight out of the clip from Katie Meyer to send it to her and said, you gotta bring that light into the locker room. And you can just tell she's just such an effervescent personality. Her smile is huge, her joy is big. And how about looking into the camera after their Sweet 16 win? We're going to the Final Four.
When you think back of her high school year, she had scoliosis, had to have surgery to correct her spine. It's amazing that she's even out playing on the floor right now.
Yeah, incredible. That was between her sophomore and junior years of high school. Roberts taking the three. Spearman offensive board. And Jaleah Williams will come and get it. Harding looking for her first points, and she's fouled. We're talking about Jaleah Williams. She had a 67-degree curve in her spine from scoliosis. This photo is absolutely incredible. This was her sophomore year going into her junior year of high school, and afterwards they were able to correct it with surgery.
That is, and her playing career was in jeopardy. Wasn't sure if she was gonna be able to play basketball or not, but when you meet Jaleah Williams and you know her person, there's nothing that's gonna keep her from playing this game. She loves it.
I remember she told us, I had no doubt I was gonna play again.
Right.
That's not surprising. Samaya Smith was whistled for her second foul. It puts Destiny Harden at the free throw line. One of two for Harden, her first point today.
Number five in the country in scoring.
Oh, a slam down by Spearman.
LSU is really struggling to produce points today, and Miami's defense has everything to do with it. The rotation is there, flooding the paint. The help is there. And then Spearman, the freshman, with the block.
Long two from Flage Johnson. Her second shot made today. Maybe that's what she needs to see it go through.
Well, after watching Flage go 0 for 7 yesterday, in practice, we saw her hit a shot and just her shoulders drop like, finally.
Swatted away by Samaya Smith. And then the foul. It's on Jasmine Roberts.
Samaya Smith with the rejection, the timing. That freshman is so long and can get off the floor.
Yeah, 6 points, 4 rebounds. Samaya Smith is tough, too. She grew up on a farm, did all the farm chores. Actually, at Christmas break, her dad said, hey, you're coming home for Christmas, but you got to do all your chores again.
But it wasn't like you got to. She wants to.
She did,
she
yeah.
said that's her happy place. She likes going home, working on the farm, and she has a horse that she loves to take care of.
Cruz and Ashley, that's the name of the horse. No field goals for Miami in 3.5 minutes.
Samaya Smith is all over the place.
And that's the third on Spearman.
In shoot around this morning, Kim Mulkey pointed out the end of the game, the plays that Samaya Smith made to close out the game. And she said, this freshman, she made big plays. She was ready and prepared to make big plays, and she has done that today.
Wide open lane for Kateri Poole. She misses, but the best backboard in the land, Angel Reese with the putback, and she has 32 double-doubles this season. That is a new SEC single season record.
Told you she'd make adjustments, Angel Reese would, in this second half.
Went 0 for 9 from the field in the first half. Offensive foul on Jasmine Roberts. Her second.
Rebounds, and she hung a 4 in her locker to remind her, and so that's been really her motivation as she has continued out this season.
You heard her tell Brooke going into the half, I'm just going to continue to get my shots and take them. My teammates cheering me on. Alexis Morris, 12 points now. An 8-1 run for LSU.
Talk about Kim Mulkey drawing up plays out of timeouts and having her team come out and execute after the diagonal screen, then hit Angel Reese. Watch this curl. Perfect timing, and Alexis Morris then available on the nail.
There's Angel's mom. Her name also Angel. She played college basketball too, wore the number 10, just like Angel.
That's why Angel, when she first got to LSU, Ryan Payne had the number 10. Angel Reese had the number 1. Payne decided not to play the rest of the season, and then Angel Reese requested, could she change her number to 10? Not only her mom wears 10, but her brother at the University of Maryland wears 10 as well.
Lola Pendande whistled for her third foul. Flage in the corner. Jasmine Roberts skying for that rebound. Almost a 3-minute scoring drought, though, for Miami. This is off LSU, stays with the Hurricanes.
That's off Miami.
Yeah.
Flage got the deflection from behind, and it went off orange. Cavender has been smothered all day.
You know, 1 for 6 for Haley Cavender, Miami's leading scorer. Really solid move from Lola Pendande.
Pendande's going to need to play the way that she did, really starting out in that first quarter against Indiana. She had six straight points.
She led Miami with 19 points in the upset of number one seeded Indiana in the second round. Kateri Poole fouled.
Lola Pendande back in this game, and I'll tell you what, Miami's training staff and their doctor did an incredible job, because watching her just even try to stand up those last 10 minutes after she got hit right about in that number two spot of her uniform. She was doubled over, needed some, the trash can actually in front of her for a while, gave her some fluids, got her up, started massaging that area, getting really deep in there by that number two on her jersey. She had to catch her breath, and wow, just for her to be able to move out there on the floor is incredible.
And not just move, Brooke, she is battling down there with Angel Reese.
Battling Angel Reese and playing to try to get the Miami Hurricanes to the Final Four for the first time in program history.
For LSU, it would be their sixth appearance in the Final Four, but they haven't been there since 2008. Samaya Smith swats it away.
Number 5 in white, Samaya Smith, this freshman has gone to work. That's a huge block inside.
Fourth foul against Lashay Dwyer of Miami. So Dwyer takes a seat, Jaleah Williams back in. This is Kateri Poole at the free throw line.
Now you got to remember, Miami found themselves down against Oklahoma State and able to come back.
And the NCAA Men's Basketball Final Four Saturday on CBS. For more information on game times and networks, go to NCAA.com. And you know, Miami, the men have already advanced to the Final Four just moments into this game. Miami women trying to also go to the Final Four in Texas.
I just wonder, do they have a comeback in them?
And Miami's going to call timeout. On game.
Well, you have Caitlin Clark that can just light it up from everywhere, going against Louisville. Louisville has struggled early in the season, but their defense seems to have gotten locked in. So this is going to be a fun one that follows us today.
We knew coming into this game, Miami and LSU, these two teams very similar. They like to score the basketball inside. They're both quick teams. It's going to be an offensive foul on Alexis Morris. It was a struggle offensively, really, for both sides in the first half. LSU went into the locker room leading 26-20.
But when you look at how both teams got here, it has been based on their defense. They've got size. They have strong rebounders. They have two very strategic coaches that have put their plan in and defensively been able to carry it out.
Williams cutting across the lane. Carla Arjavets. Rebound by Reese. If you're just tuning in, Angel Reese already has her 32nd double-double of the season. That is a new SEC record.
And when she do it? Third quarter.
Without hitting a field goal in the first half.
That's huge.
Poole steps into the three. Still neither team has hit a three. Destiny Harden looking for it. LSU ball. They say Lola Pendande touched it last.
Let's see. that looked like it went off Angel Reese to me. This call stays with LSU basketball. Approaching 1 minute to go here in the third quarter. LSU has not had a field goal in 3.5 minutes. Fajay Johnson getting on the floor. LSU has it back, and Jaleah Williams fouls her second.
Katie Meyer can't believe it.
This is the first. She was the early offense that LSU needed.
And Miami offensively, they've played fast, or probably a little faster than they've wanted to. They need to go to their very intentional, maybe horn set, get high, low, ball screen, make the LSU defense have to shift.
Yvette's is going to set up the play for the Hurricanes. And it's a kick ball. Samaya Smith runs to the table for LSU to check in. Replacing LaDeja Williams. LaDeja Williams hasn't scored for LSU today.
She did all her scoring on Friday.
Yeah, season high 24 points against Utah in the Sweet 16. Roberts, the pull-up, short. Mulkey saying, give the ball to Alexis Morris.
She wants Alexis Morris to run the point.
Last touch by Miami.
LSU wants Alexis Morris to make a play.
And she gets herself to the free throw line. That's the third on Jasmine Roberts, who is Miami's leading scorer tonight with 18 points. She had 16 of those in the first half. Two more free throws coming for LSU. They've already shot 18 free throws today. Miami, just two.
And that was a key focus. Miami had talked about not putting LSU at the free throw line. They make a living right there because they're so aggressive to the rim.
Yeah, LSU second in the nation in free throws made per game and free throws attempted per game. .5 seconds, largest lead for LSU. Alexis Morris steals it, puts up the three. A hustle play right at the buzzer for Alexis Morris, and LSU leads 10 minutes away from the final four. Kim Mulkey will talk to Brooke when we come back. They only won 9 games in the 2020-2021 season.
And this season, she lost 80% of her offense. So really, the only returning starter is Alexis Morris.
And Morris has been important today, but the transfer portal has been important all season, specifically bringing in Angel Reese to this LSU program.
Well, and Angel Reese really is at LSU because of Kateri Poole. Kateri Poole talked Angel Reese into looking at LSU. LSU wasn't even on her radar.
Jack and Roberts' shot rattles out.
What's got to change for Miami?
They're going to have to stop turning the ball over. Take care of the ball. They've got to take good shots, even create some second chance opportunities by getting some offensive rebounds.
Those are the first points for LaDasia Williams. But to your point, 12 Miami turnovers. LSU has scored 14 points off of those turnovers. Pendande, the turnaround fadeaway short. Offensive foul on Angel Reese, her second.
Pendande had a foot on the restricted area. Now she was the primary defender, though, on that one. And I do think that Angel Reese lowered that shoulder.
There's Roberts with 18 points. This is going to stay with Miami. Jasmine Roberts had 16 points in the first half, just two here in the second half. Miami only scored 7 points in the third quarter.
LSU has changed up who is guarding Jasmine Roberts. So it's been from Flaze Johnson to Alexis Morris, and now it's Kateri Poole. This has been a slugfest. It has been just a tug of war in trying to get any easy offense.
Well, we knew both programs like to score in the paint. Possession arrow to Miami, but both teams shooting under 30% from the field.
Nothing has come easy for either team tonight.
LSU has benefited from points off of Miami's turnovers and also getting the free throw line. They've been there 20 times.
There's so much on the line right now. The cream has risen to the top. That's why this game is so hard.
27 points through three quarters, the second fewest by any team in this current NCAA tournament. Talking about Miami. Norfolk State against South Carolina in the first round. That was the fewest. Flaché. Second foul on Destiny Harden. NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? LJ Johnson missing the first. You know, LSU has had to piece things together in this game, and that's been their theme all season. Piece it together, losing 80% of their scoring, adding several new players, 9 newcomers, just 5 returners. They've had to figure a lot of things out.
Well, and also, you got to buy into playing Kim Mulkey's defensive system. You have to have a commitment to defense. 1 through 5, all 5 players on the floor, or you don't get on the, or you don't get any tick.
Look, you lose 80% of your scoring and you're 5th in the nation in points per game this season. How about that?
Wow.
Morris got it back. Kateri Poole left open. We have a 3-pointer, folks. The first one of the game for either team.
LSU is feeling it.
Pendande misses. Miami now 0 for their last 8.
Not having Kateri Poole on the floor in the first half, that's what they have been missing. That 3-point threat.
So the officials talked and they reversed this call. It's ball is going to stay with Miami. Inbound to Cavender. This is Haley Cavender. She struggled to score tonight, just 1 for 6. Harden. And the putback by Spearman. That's the fourth foul against LaDasia Williams.
Spearman anticipated the shot, got inside position. That was all LaDasia Williams could do.
You know, this Miami team, there's still time here. 6:42 left on the clock. And Brooke, talking to them going into Sweet 16, remember they had that mentality of we're down 17. They kept pushing themselves.
And they kept that mentality right. It helped them beat Indiana, and then they found themselves up 21 against Villanova. So they've been on both sides of the coin. And I got to say, Destiny Harden still having a tough game shooting-wise, but she's keeping this team together. Every chance she gets, they're huddling up, and she's been a positive influence.
Yeah, she's definitely a leader for them, one of the oldest players on the team, a grad student.
Well, Miami had 3 double-digit comeback games in the regular season. They can get turned up.
There goes LaShae Dwyer. She has been in foul trouble a lot of this game, but a spark for Miami.
LSU is just such a tough team to press because of Alexis Morris. She can just handle the basketball. Angel Reese has been in the lane a long time.
Julie Cavender over to Roberts. She's looking for the three. Miami 0 for 13 from three-point land. Tigers got it back in a fresh 30. Kateri Poole. Miami basketball. The foul on Angel Reese, her third.
In those first three quarters, go and get back in the moment. You can tell Destiny Harden is emotional right now and trying to get locked in to closing out this last 5 minutes of the fourth quarter.
She's been dealing with a contact issue too, but Harden 0 for 9 from the field. 11 points in the second half for Miami. No player has scored more than 2 points. Brooke, what were they talking about during that timeout?
They're talking about being ferocious, and if you're open, let it fly. And you mentioned the contact issue. Destiny Harden spent a good portion of that timeout trying to get her contact back in. So that could be affecting your vision, CP. I mean, not having a great shooting night, maybe she can't see.
Well, that could be a confidence builder there. The score, now a turnover. The momentum could swing for the Hurricanes.
This is a 6-0 run for Miami. The turnover by Flajay Johnson, their largest run of the game. LaShae Dwyer shakes off Alexis Morris.
There's a toughness about Miami.
That's the fourth foul on Roberts.
Dwyer is probably the most competitive and ferocious Hurricane they got right now. Number 13 doing all she can to keep them in this one.
Meanwhile, LSU, their last six possessions, 0 for 5 with a turnover.
Now Miami bringing a half-court trap, zone press.
And they force the turnover. Oh, but Lashae Dwyer is down on the floor for Miami. Lashae Dwyer down for Miami.
She's been so big in the comeback. The drive to the basket, the defensive plays she just made. She brings that attitude for the Hurricanes.
Well, Katie Meyer told us she's one of their best defenders on the team. She's getting a better grasp of this offensive system, too, letting it develop patience in the offense. Lashae Dwyer down for Miami right now after leaping up into the air, helping force the turnover. So here's a look at the play. Dwyer under the basket.
She came down on her own foot.
Dwyer sitting up, the training staff for Miami still examining her left leg. And Angel Reese coming over and giving a hug to Lashae Dwyer. She's helped off the court.
On a run with Lashae Dwyer out. That could be an extra emotional motivation.
And Dwyer going all the way back to the locker room. 4 minutes to go in this game. Her Miami Hurricanes trying to come back and make it to their first Final Four. Canes on an 8-0 run. Roberts lets it fly. Still no threes for Miami. 0 for 14.
You see, Kim Mulkey wants to slow down. She wants to use a lot of the shot clock.
LSU hasn't scored in over 3.5 minutes, and they turn it over. Destiny Harden is there to take it. Williams dribbled it off her foot.
Miami can't take advantage of the opportunities they have in turning the ball over.
Yeah, 4 minute scoring now drought now for LSU. And a well short shot from Kateri Poole. Tiger ball.
We go back to what Katie Meyer told her team earlier. Stay calm, stay organized.
Miami team, they really went back to work after their loss in the ACC tournament to Virginia Tech. They called it Camp Miami, worked on the fundamentals, went back to the basics. Alexis Morris, you need a bucket? Let her work, let her cook. First field goal for LSU since the 7:18 mark in this quarter, and Destiny Harden bleeding. Vets will check in for her as the training staff from Miami looking at Destiny Harden. Came off the floor with her mouth bleeding.
Now Miami has four guards on the floor. Destiny Harden's like a 3-4 player. Now it's four guards, one post player.
And LSU has two post players down low, LaDasia Williams and Angel Reese.
Expected if Miami can't make a basket, they've got the four guards down there to bring full court pressure, but they're going to have to defend the size of LSU right now.
Morris off the side of the backboard, that stays with LSU. .2 on the shot clock for LSU. Just throw it up for Angel Reese. .13 points, 18 rebounds for Reese, who did not have a field goal in the first half.
Situations LSU is prepared for. 1.2 seconds on the clock, just put it up, and Angel Reese is able to deliver.
First foul whistled against Flaje Johnson. Julia Williams will take the free throws for Miami. This is the first. The NCAA Women's Championship continues tonight with the Elite Eight. It runs through next Sunday when we crown a champion. Every game is on the ESPN family of networks. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships.
Now, Miami's got to press right now and try to force a turnover, but you got to protect the basket.
Well, Deja Williams got loose. Timeout. 1:41 to decide who's going to the Final Four. Let's take a look at tonight's Capital One rewarding performance. Angel Reese, her 32nd double-double of the season.
13 points, 18 rebounds. A little frustrated in the first half, but the second half, she put it all together. It's not just about scoring baskets, but doing enough of what your team needs and even giving a little bit to your opponent.
Rebounds, and even when the shots weren't falling in the first half, she didn't get frustrated and let it affect the rest of her game.
And that's the maturity that she has brought all season long. We've talked to every single player in an LSU uniform, they talk about what a great leader Angel Reese is. She speaks to them the truth. She backs it up with her work ethic, and they trust her.
This is an extremely honest team, and Angel Reese sets the tone. She tells it just like it is, but they've learned to respect that, and that honesty getting them closer and closer to the Final Four.
We saw Angel Reese and Alexis Morris talking it up or chopping it up at practice earlier today. They weren't always on the same page. They eventually got there, but they talked to each other like sisters.
Don't forget, Iowa and Louisville following this game. We send two teams to the Final Four tonight. Travel on area vets, she'll check out. Hannah Cavender back in. And here's the pressure from Miami.
And LSU was expecting it. They worked on this today. The official from the far end ran in to make that call.
Third foul on Jaleah Williams. Miami has three team fouls. So one more to give before LSU would shoot on any foul.
Alexis Morris is too quick to catch.
And that's the fifth on Jasmine Roberts. That's the fourth on Roberts.
And still, LSU is not in the bonus. Miami has to foul again to put LSU at the free throw line.
Miami with one timeout.
Miami's got a foul. They want to create, and Katie Meyer is trying to ask her team to do so, but they can't catch Alexis Morris.
She's too quick. 18 points for Alexis Morris. An 8-1 run for LSU.
Miami using too much time.
And that's the fifth foul on Angel Reese.
Alexis Morris is just too hard to catch. Miami wanted to foul her, but no. Lex Luthor was able to get to the rack.
Angel Reese, her fifth foul, but her 32nd double-double of the season. 13 points, 18 rebounds. That's an SEC record.
A lot of people doubted LSU in the beginning of the season. They questioned the strength of schedule. Then people wanted to know, well, what's LSU going to be able to do when they get into the SEC? They were able to then run through the SEC, only ran into South Carolina, gave them problems. And now LSU is headed to the Final Four.
Timeout LSU. So moments ago, Angel Reese comes out of the game and Samaya Smith grabs a Sharpie, drawing a ring on that finger.
They sizing it up. Got championships on their mind.
Look, though, LSU calls timeout here. 57 seconds on the clock. A foul by either team, and they're going to the free throw line. If you're Miami, how do you approach this?
Well, Miami needs to try to defend. They try to get a 5-second count or force a turnover. If not, they need to foul right away and put LSU at the free throw line so they can try to lengthen this game as long as possible.
LSU less than a minute away from some history. It's been 15 years since the Tigers have been to the Final Four. 2008 was the year. They made five straight Final Four appearances from 2004 to 2008.
Now LSU, or Miami, wants to try to force LSU to inbound the ball to LaDasia Williams. She's the one free throw shooting wise. You don't want it to go to Alexis Morris.
And Alexis Morris had to hit those crucial free throws to give LSU the lead on Friday. And then to ice the game, four free throws in a row for Alexis Morris. So she's a big reason why they are here in the Elite Eight.
When big moments hit, it seems like Alexis Morris just slows down. She is just calm, cool, and collected. And then she misses the free throw.
Coming up next, Iowa and Louisville, still 5 minutes away from that tip. It'll be here on ESPN. Miami's got to score fast.
I don't know how fast they can score enough. But that's the last thing you want to do is foul.
That's by Flaje Johnson, her second. People talked about LSU's non-conference schedule. Kim Mulkey made that schedule. She didn't know the pieces that she was going to have coming in the transfer portal, but it gave them time to figure each other out.
Exactly. And she said there's such thing as overscheduling. You either overschedule or underschedule. And until you know what your team is going to be like, you don't want to take on too tough a schedule because you've got to build that confidence. And you got so many new players that had to learn her system.
So timeout taken by LSU. Quickly, let's go to the studio. Looking forward to that game. These are the eight teams remaining in the tournament as Elstead, Iowa, and Louisville coming up next. And we're about to decide whether it's LSU or Miami going to the Final Four first.
I'm still amazed in what LSU has been able to do in Kim Mulkey in just two seasons at LSU. She's got this team going to a Final Four.
Alexis Morris is fouled.
When you look at the difference that Angel Reese has made coming in, then the transfer of LaDasia Williams, Kateri Poole coming in from Ohio State. And you have last year Poa as well. The contributions, the buy-in of those four transfers have been huge.
Morris steals it away. And Katie Meyer telling her team, don't foul.
There's still about 10-second difference with the shot clock.
Morris taking the three. The last second bucket, 22 points for Jasmine Roberts. And Katie Meyer calls timeout for a sub. She'll take Destiny Harden out. What a leader, what a veteran she has been for Miami. Helping this Miami program make history, getting to their first Elite Eight.
She's had some big moments at the University of Miami. Remember in the ACC tournament, the win over Louisville. Big time player, Destiny Harden.
Kim Kim Mulkey's working magic at LSU. The Tigers back to the